Welcome to the lecture series of Z-transform. Today we are going to see the next topic under Z-transform is method of residues. To find Z-inverse using residue theorem. This is what the next topic under the Z-inverse. So look at this. If Z of f of n equals f of z, then f of n, which gives the inverse Z-transform of f of z, is obtained from the result f of n is equal to 1 by 2 pi I integral over C z power n minus 1 f of z dz. Can call this as equation 1, where C is the closed contour which encloses all the poles of the integrand. By residue theorem, integral over C z power n minus 1 f of z dz equal to 2 pi I sum of residues of z power n minus 1 into f of z at its poles. This is our equation 2. Substituting equation 2 in 1, we can get f of n is equal to sum of the residues of z power n minus 1 f of z at its poles. So this is what the procedure now we are going to do. So don't confuse much. It's very simple. First we will take the given Z inverse of whatever given, that we can take that as by partial fraction method how we used to take capital F of z. By the same manner here also we will take the inside of Z inverse is our F of z. So we have to form the first equation. This is the residue theorem. So F of n we have to write, that is nothing but 1 by 2 pi integral over C z power n minus 1 F of z dz. And substituting that, we can cancel the terms in the z power n minus 1 and the f of z. Then we can get some integrand. For that integrand, we need to find the residues. And then we have to add all the residues. Again, back to equation 1. This 2 pi I, 2 pi I will cancel. That's why we are getting the final answer as f of n equal to sum of the residues of z power n minus 1 into f of z at its poles. So this is what the residue theorem. So based on this only, now we are going to do the problem. Look at the first question. Find z inverse of z by z minus 1 into z minus 2 using residue theorem. So in the question, if suppose using residue theorem is not given, we can go any method. That is, we can go for partial fraction also. But if it is given in the question, using residue theorem means we have to do by that method only. So look at the solution. So first we will take what is given inside the bracket of z inverse as our f of z. So let f of z equal to z by z minus 1 into z minus 2. And then you can take f of n equal to z inverse of f of z. Okay, so now z power n minus 1 into f of z. Why we are finding this one? No? To apply the result. So z power n minus 1 into what is our f of z? F of z is z by z minus 1 into z minus 2. So z power n minus 1 can be written as z power n into 1 by z into z by z minus 1 into z minus 2. We can cancel the z. Okay, so this is equal to z power n divided by z minus 1 into z minus 2. Okay, so here to find the poles, we have to equate the denominator to 0. So equate denominator to 0. So when you are equating this to 0, z minus 1 into z minus 2 equal to 0, which implies z equal to 1, 2. Okay, so therefore the poles are, this is the way we have to find out the poles. The poles are z equal to 1, comma z equal to 2. Here the degree z power minus 1 power is 1 and z minus 2 the power is 1. Therefore the poles are simple pole. If the degree is 1, the poles are called simple pole. If degree is 2, means pole of order 2. degrees 3 means pole of order 3. Like that we have to write. In this problem, the poles are very simple pole. So now we are going to find the residue at each poles. Residue of function z power n minus 1 into f of z at z equal to 1. The formula is, what is the pole? Pole is z equal to 1. So limit z tends to 1, z minus 1 into that function, z power n minus 1 into f of z. We have taken z power n by z minus 1 into z minus 2. Now we can cancel the z minus 1 and z minus 1. So what is the remaining limit? Z tends to 1, z power n by z minus 2. Now we have to allow the z tends to 1. So what will happen? 1 power n divided by 1 minus 2. So which is equal to minus 1 power n. This is the first residue. Now the second residue. We have two residues at z equal to 1 and z equal to 2. So now the residue at z equal to 2. So likewise, what is the result? Result is limit z tends to 2, z minus 2 into that function. What is that? Z power n by z minus 1 into z minus 2. Now we can cancel the z minus 2, z minus 2. So what is the remaining? Remaining limit z tends to 2, z power n by z minus 1. Now allow the z tends to 2. So what will happen? 2 power n divided by 2 minus 1. That is equal to 2 power n. So now we got the two residues. Therefore, what is our f of n? F of n is equal to, by residue theorem, what is the f of n? Sum of residues of z power n minus 1 into f of z at its poles. So what are the poles? Z equal to 1 and z equal to 2. We'll write the first one as positive pole. So positive answer. So 2 power n minus 1 power n, where n greater than or equal to 0. Therefore, z inverse of, what is the question? Z inverse of z by z minus 1 into z minus 2 equals 2 power n minus 1 power n, where n greater than or equal to 0. So this is f of n is nothing but what? Z of z inverse of z by z minus 1 into z minus 2 is nothing but what? It is nothing but f of n. Because we have taken this term as f of z. So z of f of n equals capital F of z. That is why f of n equals z inverse of f of z. So if this is not that much important, you can write the answer like this. Thank you for watching.